Because in one way,
speaking during the Kenya National Chamber of Commerce and Industry annual general meeting in Nairobi, the organization's national chairman Kiprono Kitonyi called on the government to remove trade barriers. These include delayed payments that have left many SMEs without free-flowing capital. Small and medium-sized enterprises are owned over 2 billion Kenya shillings by the national and county governments. The chairman also wanted the government to grant a tax amnesty on businesses that have defaulted on their tax obligation due to delay payments.
So I would like to suggest that this late payments bill is moved as fast as possible in order for people to have money circulating in the economy. At the same time, because of all that money that is sitting, many people have fallen afoul with the credit reference agencies.
During the AGM, the chamber also requested the Minister of Trade and Industry to introduce a bill that mandates every business to have chamber membership as a way of strengthening the chamber. On his part, the Cabinet Secretary for Trade, Industry and Cooperatives, Peter Munya, informed the gathering that the government will be introducing a regulatory guide to delay payments. This, they hope, will offer guidance on how the government and SMEs will be transacting business.
The SME sector is actually the biggest driver of growth and development and even employment. Effective analysis that has been made clearly shows that if you want to create jobs, generate more jobs, transform the economy, the sector you need to focus on is the SME sector.
According to the Kenya National Bureau of Statistics, there are more than 17 million SMEs registered in Kenya, with 98% of enterprises contributing 25% of the country's GDP and employing up to 50% of the workforce. Kevin Sewe, Switch TV.